Do you need a full face helmet? Well, in this video, we'll talk you through the pros and cons of an open face or a trail helmet and the full face option. So hopefully at the end, you'll be able to weigh up if you do or not.
But let's look at that modern day open face helmet and the technology that goes into it. I'm going to kick it off with the strap. This is a conventional chin strap. So it goes over your ears, around them, underneath your chin, clicks into place. A little bit more about the straps is this bit here. Now, some other helmets have some adjustment around the ear, whereas the POC one here has got this bridge, which is a size that will fit anyone. And again, less faff and adjustment. With these modern day open face helmets, there's adjustments everywhere. A bit like this peak, you can fully adjust it to give you a little bit more room so you can run glasses or even so goggles on your face as well. Plus you can store them as well. You can store your goggles and your glasses. With the glasses, you can store them within your little visor peaks right here, or even better is your goggles, just like this. So what type of rider would wear glasses and what type of rider would wear goggles? Now with the glasses, it's more of a trail ride. You're out there on single track. You want to keep your eyes protected from the sticks and the elements. Likewise, the sun and dust if you're following some friends. With the goggles, it's more aimed at the enduro rider that wants to be riding in muddier conditions or colder conditions. Technology has come on leaps and bounds within open face helmets and including all other helmets as well. But we're gonna talk about distributing all of that impact force if you were to have a crash. Now, with this helmet here, this one's got the MIPS Integra system, which is a rotational bit within this helmet. So if you were to have a crash, it would twist and move instead of your neck doing that. And POC have their own, which is POC Spin, which is a gel-like pad, as well as a little plastic cage within it. So that would rotate as well on a force. And you've also got Reco built into your helmet, which is an NFC medical ID tag built into the helmet. So you can put all your details into it. And if something were to go wrong or if you were to get lost, it would send a beacon out to a system that they can track you on so they can come find you. And all of that is built into this helmet, which is a lot. And that's a good peace of mind. So if you were to have a crash, they can come find you. The adjustments on these new helmets are vast. You've got a number of them, depending on how you want the helmet to fit to the contour of your skull. You've got this bit adjustment on the rear. You've got this little dial as well to just bring in the helmet to give you a nice snug fit so it's not so loose. The modern day enduro helmet has a lot more protection on the rear, which brings this bit right down. A bit like this one right here. It's a lot deeper, just to give you a lot more protection around the back. This is not in every helmet, it's only in a select few that you can see that has this big droop on the rear. Like I said, to give you a lot more protection when you're riding gnarlier terrain. Right, enough about the open face helmets. Let's go over to Neil to talk about full face helmets.
So do you need a full face helmet? Well, it's all down to personal choice, and I'll talk you through when I think I need one and when I definitely do use one. And let's start with the type of bike. So if I'm riding a downhill bike, then I'll always use a full face helmet. Whereas with an enduro bike, I don't always. Although sometimes the speeds aren't that different. With a downhill bike, I'm likely to be somewhere where I'm either using an uplift or I'm pushing the bike back up. So I can take my full face helmet off and I'm not gonna get too hot. So with a downhill bike, you're likely to be riding tracks that are very fast as well and technical. So downhill racers will always wear full face helmets. It's part of the rules for most races anyway. But definitely if I'm up in the speed, I'm coming somewhere like Fort William, riding the downhill track here, I wouldn't ride this place in an open face helmet. I would always choose a full face. Let's talk about the anatomy of a full face helmet, because there are actually different types of full face. So this is the POC Coron. This is their full downhill helmet, but you can get different full face helmets, ones with removable chin bars, or the more newer style of enduro helmets where they're much more vented. But with a full face, you're always sort of putting protection against comfort and breathability. So the helmets with more protection aren't gonna be as light and as breathable as the lighter versions. This is the Coron downhill helmet. We can see we're talking full protection on this helmet. So this helmet is designed for gravity riding or racing as much as anything, and free ride, where you can see, yes, ventilation is definitely thought about. You've got this sort of entry and exit ports when you're riding, but when you're not riding, air isn't going through it, then they can feel a bit warm, these things, but it's all about protection, having the maximum coverage. You will more often than not see riders with full face helmets also using goggles, definitely downhill racers. Just gives you that extra protection as well. Great for vision, so stopping anything getting into your eyes, mild or anything like that, but also it's just covering that part of your face as well, so just better protected. In the past, in my downhill racing days, I've fallen off a bike an awful lot. I'm sure I won't surprise you if you're used to watching GMBN videos. And in the past, I've actually given myself a black eye because the goggle frame has hit the floor, slammed in like that, and it's hit and pushed into my eye. But I wouldn't like to think about what would have happened if I wasn't wearing goggles. So definitely feels the best if you've got a full face helmet and goggles. You've also got the Coron Air version of this helmet. It looks very similar, it's the same silhouette, but you can see more ventilation at the front. So that's definitely more of an enduro helmet for those times when you're pedaling harder and you want that airflow a bit better coming into the front of the helmet. Less protection maybe, but you've still got the same coverage. Features to look for when you're buying a full face helmet. Some of them will have breakaway peaks like this does. So that's nice. Sometimes you'll find if you do sort of hit that part first on the ground, if it doesn't move, it can actually move the helmet. So a lot of these helmets have breakaway peaks. Also cheek pads, you want them to fit nicely against your cheeks. So adjustable cheek pads or some smaller pads that go behind them. You'll find that when they're tight to your cheeks, the helmet will feel super secure. Also with that fastening strap underneath your chin, helmet just won't move in the event of a crash. Also, you're seeing a lot of these days, these sort of safety features on the pads so they can pull release. So in the event of a big crash, if you do maybe have a head injury or a neck injury, people that come to help you can safely remove these pads without sort of jerking the helmet on your head, and the helmet should come off nice and easy. There's no doubt about it, for riding where you're likelier to have a big crash, somewhere like this, Fort William, then a full face is the choice of helmet to have. If you're not used to them, they can feel a little claustrophobic to begin with, especially if it's hot. But designers have worked hard on that to make sure they're super ventilated. Also, they've put chambers in for your ears, so there's a bit of space there, and that can make them feel a lot less claustrophobic. There's another option, which can seem quite appealing to some riders, are these helmets with removable chin bars. Hands up, I've never actually used one because I've never been sponsored by a brand that does them, so I've got no experience. And I think they're probably pretty good for hotter climates. If you're riding something like an enduro bike where you've got a really big mountain, you've got one big climb, so you can take the chin guard off. Don't forget you've got to store it somewhere, so you've probably got to ride with a backpack as well and then clip it back on for the descent. And that's somewhere that I've never really ridden that much. So a helmet that I guess I probably wouldn't use anyway, even if I had the choice, but I definitely think that could work for some people. From my experience, I raced downhill for a long time and I have smashed more than a handful of full face helmets that have been completely written off, and I wouldn't like to have seen what I'd been doing in an open face helmet, but I would never have chosen one for a downhill race anyway. I've also had a brain bleed from a big road bike crash where I was wearing an open face helmet. However, that helmet wasn't really touched that much. I smashed my face pretty hard, so that caused it. And that wasn't a ride where I would have been wearing a full face helmet anyway. So I've sort of seen all ends of the spectrum for big crashes and some head injuries. But of course, it's best to avoid any of those. So if you're riding aggressive stuff, then I definitely think a full face helmet is gonna be a good choice. Plus, don't forget that if you're racing, sometimes you'll have to ride in one. And also some bike parks, if you go places with gondolas, often they will make sure that you do wear a full face helmet. So check that out before you go there. So do you need a full face helmet? Well, I think if you ride fast technical terrain, then yes, I think you do. But I think you should look through all the options. Like I said, you can go for the full protection, but what you gain in protection and you lose in breathability. And with those helmets that do have more space to let air in, that also lets mud and potentially things like branches go in. Also think about trying them on, because people do have different shape helmets, so you want to get the most comfortable helmet that you're going to wear for the most amount of time to make it, you know, make it do its work properly. So check out all the options and really think about that protection to comfort and breathability ratio and get that right for the type of riding you do. And if you do get one, it doesn't have to be the only helmet you ride. If like me, you can choose the right kit and equipment to make sure that you've got the appropriate stuff for that ride, to make sure that you're comfortable and safe. Give this video a thumbs up if you love the feel of having a full face helmet on your head and it's time to bomb down a hill. And yeah, leave some comments, tell us what you think about this, and if you have a full face helmet in your kit bag.